Yeah, dear student, we continue with our chapter 4 ratio analysis, and our today's ratio is net profit ratio. So this ratio established between the relationship between the net profit and revenue from operation. Revenue from operation is a new word according to 2013 amendment, otherwise it was net sales. It shows the percentage of net profit earned on revenue from operation. Okay? So the formula of net profit ratio equal to net profit into 100 upon revenue from operation. Or that is net sales. Clear? You might have studied last year net sales, but in this book, company account, after 2013 amendment, it is called revenue from operations. Clear? Now, how to calculate net profits? So it's very simple. Net profit equals to revenue from operation minus cost of revenue from operation. Clear? That was COGS actually. Minus operating expenses. Minus non-operating expenses plus non-operating income and minus tax. Okay. If you remember last year, you have prepared profit and loss account. After gross profit, what we are going to subtract? We are going to separate all operating expenses and non-operating expenses. Clear? In the end, adding non-operating income minus tax. So what you will get is net profit. Clear? So now what is the objective and significance of calculating this ratio? So it is an indicator of overall efficiency of the business. Higher the net profit ratio means better is the financial position of the business. So higher net profit ratio always indicate the good financial health of the enterprise. This ratio helps in determine the operational efficiency of the business. How efficiently you are doing your business. Consider the example of Jio Network. Even in during the pandemic time, they have collected record revenue of 10,000 crore. They have called one investor, and that person, if you remember, the biggest oil refinery of UAE, Aramco, has invested a very good amount in the Reliance Jio Network. So an increase in the ratio over the previous period shows improvement in the operational efficiency of the enterprise, and decline means otherwise. A comparison with the industry standard is also an indicator of the efficiency of business. Clear? So in this way it is calculated. Now we are going to solve one numerical. One example is there. See example 1112. Given on page 4.71. Okay. See, gross profit ratio is given. Gross profit ratio of the enterprise is 20%. Cash sales ₹2 lakh and credit sales 90% of total sales. Okay. 90% of total sales. Indirect expenses. Indirect expenses of the companies are 20,000. Calculate net profit ratio. Okay. So first we are going to calculate the total sales or total revenue from operation. Find out total sales. So total sales equal to cash sales plus credit sales. So we don't know the total sales. Let total sales be X. Cash sales 2 lakh प्लस क्रेडिट से 90% ऑफ टोटल, सो 90/100 इनटू एक्स, क्लियर? एक्स इक्वल टू अगेन 2 लाख प्लस 9x/10, क्लियर? नाउ ब्रिंग इट हियर, सो एक्स माइनस 9x/10 इक्वल्स टू 2 लाख. So if you simplify this or take an example of LCM of this, it will come to 10x/9x/10. So your x equal to cross multiply 20 lakh. So your total sales is 20 lakh. Clear? So now you have got the total sales. Now what you need is net profit. Now gross profit ratio is 25%. So find out gross profit. Gross profit equals to sales is your total sales is 20 lakh into 25%. So that comes to 5 lakh. Now your gross profit is 5 lakh. Now we find out net profit out of that. Okay? So net profit equals to gross profit minus indirect expenses. So your gross profit is 5 lakh and indirect expenses are given 20,000. So your net profit is 4,80,000. Now we have got both the variables, net profit and revenue from operations. So see, 4,80,000 net profit upon 20 lakh into 100. Solve it. So what you will get is 24%. In this way, net profit ratio is calculated. It's just a simple arithmetic calculation. This you have already done last year also, while doing your final account. Clear? Okay. Now our next ratio is ROI, that is return on investment or return on capital employed. Okay. So our next ratio is ROI, return on investment, ROI or return on capital employed. Return on investment or return on capital employed shows the relationship of the profit before interest and tax with the capital employed. What relationship is shown? Profit before interest and tax and the capital employed. The net result of the operation of a business is either profit or loss. The sources fund used in the business is to earn this profit or loss are proprietors or shareholder funds and all. Computation. So this ratio is computed by dividing net profit before interest, tax and dividend by capital employed. In the form of formula, this is expressed as follows. So ROI equals to net profit before interest, tax and dividend. Into 100 upon capital employed. This ratio and this ratio is expressed as percentage. Now what is capital employed? Again, we have already studied capital employed means total money invested in the business. So capital employed is computed following either liabilities approach or asset approach. It should be noted that whichever approach is followed, the amount of capital employed will be same. So capital employed is calculated by both the approaches. either with the liability side or with the asset side. In both ways you can calculate the amount of capital employed. Okay, na? So first is, see what comes under liability side. So first is shareholders fund. Okay, now what does it consist of? It consists of share capital plus reserve and surplus. Reserve and surplus. Clear? Sometimes what happens, debit balance of profit and loss is also given. In that case, it is subtracted from that. Then, non-current liabilities. Then, non-current liabilities. What is it concern non-current liabilities? That consists of long-term borrowings. Long-term borrowings and long-term provisions. Okay, this is, in this way, capital employed is calculated from the liability side. Okay, now, we see that from assets how it is calculated. So, what we are going to take? Non-current assets. Non-current assets. Now, what comes under it? So, first is fixed assets. Fixed asset, it shows tangible and intangible. Both type of assets will come. Then non-current investments. Second is non-current investments. And third is long-term loans and advances. Clear? And next is working capital. That is equal to current asset minus current liabilities. Working capital is the excess of current asset over current liabilities. So always remember, answer will come same from both the approaches. Objective and significance. This ratio is calculated to measure the overall performance, profitability of the enterprise. It measures how efficiently the resources of the business are used. Return on capital employed is a fair measure of the profitability of any business concerned, with the result that the performance of the different industries may be measured. An enterprise should have a satisfactory ratio. To assess whether the ratio is satisfactory or not, it should be compared with its own ratios of the past years or with the ratios of similar enterprise in the industry or with the industry average. Clear? Okay, now we are going to solve one numerical to have a better understanding of this ratio. Okay, see, we are going to solve one numerical. That is example 116. Net profit after tax and tax is given, that is 6 lakh. 10% debentures are given. Net profit after interest and tax, that is 6 lakh. 10% debentures of rupees 10 lakh. Tax rate was there, tax at the rate 40%, and capital employed is given. Here we are not supposed to calculate, capital employed is already given, that is 80 lakh. So here what we have to calculate? Net profit after interest and tax is given. So we have to calculate net profit before interest, tax and dividend. Clear? So now NPAT. NPAT is given. Net profit after tax 6 lakh. Now this is after the deduction of 40%. So this means this is 60%. So make a reciprocal of 60% into 100 upon 60. So your what you got is NPBT, net profit before tax. So your NPBT is equals to 10 lakh. Clear? Now interest. Interest is on 10% debenture at the rate rupees 10 lakh. So add interest in that. That comes to 1 lakh. So your 11 lakh is NPBIT and dividend into 100 upon capital employed. Clear? Now put down the figures in the formula. So that is 11 lakh upon 80 lakh into 100. Solve this. You will get the answer. So that comes to near about 13.75% Clear? In this way, you are supposed to solve these type of ratio. Clear? So from my side, this chapter is completed. Please solve more and more numerical to have a better understanding of this chapter. Thank you. Thanks for joining.